This is Farfetch Threads, our people podcast, where you can hear the real stories about life as a Farfetcher.
Hello, and welcome to Farfetch Threads, our people podcast. My name is Amanda Henderson, and I'm on the partner success team here at Farfetch. As a partner success manager, my role is to provide strategic support to our branded boutique partners. One of the partners I've had the privilege of working with over the years is Stadium Goods, and today I'm here with none other than co-founder of Stadium Goods, John McPheters. Welcome, John, and thanks for coming on the pod today.
Well, thanks for having me. Excited to be here.
Yep, couldn't be more excited. And hey, look, it looks like we're both repping the set today in Stadium Goods apparel. So do you mind giving the people a taste of the sauce that you got on?
Today I'm wearing a Stadium Goods zip-up hoodie. It's one of the older line, not the new eco sweats that we have that are really exciting that I've been wearing most days. So you're catching me on an off day without the eco sweat. And I also have a limited edition Chicago launch t-shirt from when we opened the Chicago store. So always flagging the SG brand everywhere I go.
Yeah, and always looking fly. I mean, super exciting about the, you know, the eco-friendly products, but this still looks good. And really, I mean, today's about you, the Stadium Goods team, and the Stadium Goods brand life and culture. But if I may also flex for 1 minute here and let the people know what I have on, I'm wearing exclusive, employee exclusive Stadium Goods today. One of my favorites, actually, it's this kind of cantaloupe color. And on the back, it says, putting in work since 2015. And I actually thought this kind of plays into the Stadium Goods story very well, which John would love, you know, if you can, one, let us know what is Stadium Goods. And then two, tell us a bit about yourself and, you know, how did this whole thing get started?
For sure. Putting in work from 2015, that's a good way to kick it off. So, Stadium Goods is a little over 5 years old. We're a consignment marketplace that's focused on sneakers and streetwear and other collectibles. A lot of what we sell is through our stadiumgoods.com website, our app, our retail presences. We have two stores, one in Soho in New York and one in Chicago that pretty recently opened. And also through Farfetch. We sell a ton of product through Farfetch. Our partnership with Farfetch is obviously very strong for a bunch of reasons, but the full catalog, for the most part, is available on Farfetch as well through Farfetch.com in the app. And I think in general, a big part of the vision of Stadium Goods when we launched a little over 5 years ago was really to clean up the idea of what aftermarket meant to the world. Our goods are consignment, which means people have bought them through other channels. They might have bought them through retail. They might have bought them online. They might be trading them and swapping them. A whole variety of reasons why someone might have these very sought after products. But we saw a big opportunity to really present a rich consumer experience, complete with branding and customer service and the right level of editorial content around these goods and really elevate the offering. And at the time, it was a new idea. And you know, we've obviously taken it a long ways from those early days back in 2015 when we kicked off. So yeah, I think the other big part that's really critical for us, retail is a big piece, and it's not just about selling product through retail, but really using that as a launch pad to create that story and that editorial content around our brand and the products that we sell. And that's a big part. You know, I think a lot of people struggle with retail, but for us, it's a huge point of success and something we're very proud of as we've built it out over the past few years.
Yeah. And I think, you know, I mean, from my personal experience visiting the New York store, the store in Soho, there's a really consistent branding overall from the online experience to also the physical retail experience at the Stadium Goods stores. You know, the product really shines. I think that the stores are always super fresh and clean. But there's something about, you know, you walk in the store and the product is just highlighted and displayed in so many beautiful different ways. So I think amazing job, and you know, congrats on all of the success that you've had with getting Stadium Goods up and running, and then all of the retail locations that you have. Curious to also just kind of go back a little bit even further. So if you can give us more of the origin story of Stadium Goods. So how did this idea come about? You know, was it something that you just woke up one day and decided, hey, I'm gonna start this company called Stadium Goods? Have you always been into sneakers? Would love to know more of the history behind that.
It's funny, before we started Stadium Goods, I was talking to my mother about sneakers, and I've been in the sneaker space for quite some time, acquire stadium goods. And I said, you know, Mom, I'm about to double down and put a lot more eggs in the sneaker basket. What do you think? And she's like, you know, you've been really into sneakers since you were about 9. And it's grown year in, year out, again and again and again and again since that time. She's like, I don't see it changing or going anywhere. And I think at the time, sneakers were much more niche than they are today, you know, and it was sort of on its road to turning mass and becoming something that was much more widely adopted. So I think part of it was just seeing that opportunity and really believing in the market for the products that we were selling. So in terms of origin story, just to kind of take a step back, you know, I had been, there were two things that were very relevant. And I'd been in the space kind of collecting sneakers and industry wear for a long, long time prior to stadium goods. But I had the unique opportunity of running social media for Nike on the agency side for a good number of years. And that taught me a lot about branded content and consumer communication. And we were at the time, Nike was publishing their content across so many different channels. It was Tumblr, it was Instagram, it was Facebook, it was Twitter, you know, and each category had its own handle. So we got to learn how to kind of tailor the voices and present a lot. And it was a big team that I ran, and it was a pretty successful piece of business. I was also very closely involved with a company called Flight Club that was early days in consignment retail. And I think, so as I grew, you know, I got to a place where I met Jed. Jed and I had a project called Swarm Mobile that we had been a part of, and we were lucky enough to kind of be part of an exit, that company selling to Groupon. And Jed and I realized that we wanted to be partners in whatever we were going to do, and we didn't quite know what it was going to be. So stepped away from all the other things that I had done prior and just hunkered down and tried to figure out what that next move was. And we had some crazy ideas that never saw the light of day. But the one that we really got excited about was stadium goods. And for us, we just saw so much potential in the market and an opportunity to really elevate that experience, like we were talking about prior, and started lining things up and ran for it as hard as we could, you know? And I mean, the rest, obviously, it has been a little over 5 years at this point, but if you think about some of the accomplishments along the path to where we are now, I kind of like to talk about, so Forerunner Ventures investing in stadium goods was huge for us. LVMH, we were their first investment in sneakers and streetwear at the time. This was before Virgil. It was a huge shattering of a glass ceiling of sorts for aftermarket sneakers in our space. Obviously, getting acquired by Farfetch was a huge success and incredible moment for us as a business. And I think seeing the synergies between Farfetch and stadium goods and how much there was there to really accomplish through that acquisition, you know, that was obviously a very exciting time and a ground shifting moment. And then since then, we've had many other wins and accomplishments. You know, it's been a pretty wild ride in a relatively short period of time. But yeah, lots of good things. You know, looking back, I think the thing that Jen and I are most proud of is really the team and the people and how we've all come together, both on the stadium good side and the Farfetch side, to build and innovate.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I mean, first off, congratulations to you and Jed for the successful business that you've built. You know, and there's a lot of incredible dynamics here with this story, from friendship and partnership to tech and sneaker culture. It's just honestly an unbelievable story. And it also raises the question, John, are we ever going to see this on the big screen? And if so, who would be cast as John McPheters?
You know, I don't think anybody really wants to hear from me. Necessarily. But, you know, I do think it is a very unique story. You know, a lot of times when you hear about startups that are successful, it's kind of like a Silicon Valley pedigree, people that have been in that space for a long time. I think that our story is unique in terms of the cast of characters and all the things that we did to get where we were.
And we have you to thank for getting Nike the blue check verified on IG. Is that right? Just kidding.
Actually, you know, that did happen. That did happen on my watch.
Oh, amazing. Look at that.
Yeah, you know, I'll tell you something that's kind of a lesser known fact about that. So at Nike, which is the main handle at the time, because Nike was broken up into all these categories. So you had Nike basketball, Nike women's, Nike running, Nike golf, Nike everything that you can imagine, right? No one was actually minding the at Nike handle at the time that we
started
to it. And it's because it didn't have a category under it, you know? That's kind of like a little bit of a history lesson, but it also speaks to how social content has evolved on a timeline, and there was a lot of things that people were still feeling through and figuring out. So I was more proud about getting stadium goods verified. That was for me, that was a bigger accomplishment for us. But
of course. And yeah, thanks for sharing that. I think our listeners love history lessons, so we appreciate that. And yeah, you know, you talked about the team and the family at Stadium Goods, and this is kind of bringing me to my next question, which is, you know, can you talk about the culture at Stadium Goods and the talent that you guys have been able to acquire?
Just really, really proud and humbled by the team that we've been able to pull together across every category of the business. You know, if you think about our retail team, for example, and the innovation that we've done there, and opening Chicago and seeing just how incredibly that story has unfolded into the Chicago landscape. You talk about tech, you talk about our finance evolution, you talk about marketing and raising the bar, or our apparel practice. You know, we've gone from being a very small team, if you go back 2-3 years ago, to being a much more sizable team that can execute on a much higher level. And I think that comes down to passion. It comes down to good people in the trenches with us and a culture that people are excited to be a part of. You know, like, it's, there's so many things that lend themselves to creating a great work environment. I think a lot of it is autonomy and people feeling like they have control about control in terms of the things that they're working on and the outcomes that they can impact. I think it speaks to feeling comfortable in your own skin and being who you are at work. But there's a lot there, you know, and I think especially over during the COVID times, you know, it's created some interesting challenges because we're very much a family and we love to meet face to face and you know, get together, and we haven't been able to do that. So a lot of that is all, obviously it's all digital now, beyond the retail fulfillment teams that are still present in person. But yeah, I mean, at the same time, we've flourished during this time, and it's been great to see. And I think we've just done all we can to try to make sure everyone's feeling good and on a great path within the culture.
Amazing. And you know, I know I mentioned that I've had the privilege of working with the Stadium Goods team, and I just couldn't agree more. There's experts at every end of the business, from, you know, some of the most creative geniuses in the world. And then you have, you know, sophisticated tech experts that are programmers and amazing at coding. And then you have really incredible people in the logistics and operations space. So again, congratulations just on the team that you've built. And I've always felt a part of the Stadium Goods family whenever I was there, or whenever I, you know, had the opportunity to work with colleagues. So it's just a great culture and something really amazing and fun to be a part of.
Well, thank you for that. And we've enjoyed working with you and hanging out with you as well.
Great. That's no mutual. All right. So in the world we live in today, you know, you don't necessarily have to be a sneakerhead to know that the sneaker market is booming. So I'm curious to know, as a key player in the industry, how does Stadium Goods differentiate itself from the competition?
There's a couple key ways. I think so. One thing to note, so it's, if you look at our space, and there are a good handful of players in our space, one of our key premises is that we're holding the inventory. It's something that we have in hand. It's been authenticated, and it's ready to ship. So if you're comparing us to an eBay or a StockX or a whoever else, peer-to-peer player, right? That's a key difference. And I think that aligns, I mean, it's a huge alignment with us in Farfetch, in that we can meet the SLAs, we can ship products out. You know, consumers, in our mind, consumers that are looking for a rich experience, they want to know when they're going to receive the products, and they want to know exactly what they're getting. And so that's one big piece of differentiation, is that we are holding it and it can ship out right away. So that's a big piece. I think secondarily, in terms of authentication, our authentication education and practices, we're best in the business. We've focused tremendously on this area, and it's something that we continue to innovate on and educate around. I mean, it's a big piece of continuing to drive the business as well. And I think beyond that, it's, you know, if you go back on a timeline 7 years, 9 years, wherever, and you were looking for one of these rare pairs of sneakers, you might find them on Craigslist. You might meet someone at a Starbucks or in a parking lot to make a trade. You know, it felt very different than it does today. And I think we've done tremendous work to really elevate that overall experience. And a lot of that is through the storytelling and the content and the bringing people up to speed with the background on the products and doing it the right way with video and images and kind of just everything that you can create to really add sexiness to the products through the right lens. And I think that's done a lot to drive the overall market. You know, people know more about sneakers now than they did before. They know more about the backstory of and the lineage of different silhouettes. They understand when something drops, they kind of know more about the catalog. And that's also a huge point of differentiation. And then, I mean, I could give you 100 of these probably, but the last one I would say, just to kind of take it back to retail, we've really done all that we can to make the retail experience not intimidating and welcoming for anyone that walks in the door. You know, that 85-year-old grandmother that's coming to buy something for her young grandkid that is just looking at sneakers for the first time. And that shouldn't be an innovation, but in ways in the sneaker market, that really was, you know, it wasn't the most welcoming place 5, 6, 7 years ago. And I think bringing in as many people as possible and doing everything that you can to educate and be welcoming in general and kind of creating a brand that is rich, but also warm and soft for a lot of people has worked. And that was a differentiator as well, along with the retail.
Yeah, and definitely well said. I couldn't agree more, where it's just, you walk in a store, you see this luxury presence, but still you have these people that are almost like neighbor-like and they're very friendly. They have all of the education in the world about the product and there's something for everyone. So John, we've talked about, you know, the ways that Stadium Goods creates exciting experiences and content for customers. And I'm curious if we can go a little bit deeper here to talk about, you know, some of the ways that you guys use your social media channel and platform to connect with the customers.
Yeah. So look, there's a wide variety of stuff that we could talk about. I think we very early on embraced video. It's funny, when we were launching, Facebook Live was all the rage, right? That was pre-Instagram stories, that was pre-TikTok, you know. But we were able to really get our content strong during those early days from a video standpoint, and then have iterated on it a good number of times. And sometimes it might be like simple unboxing videos that walk people through products in a way that they feel good about. Or it might be stories that can be a wide variety of formats. You know, you've obviously got video content, you've got live video content, you've got surveys and engagement drivers and things that people can kind of click through and pick answers on things. Those have been really good in terms of driving engagement and interest. And then as newer channels have popped up, like TikTok, for example, we've seen great success against our TikTok videos. And I think one of the other things that's really exciting for us is having many people on the team, the Stadium Goods team, that want to take part in creating this content, whether it be some of the shorter form videos or taking part in people to come and shoot videos in our space, or creating TikTok videos, you name it, models in our photo shoots. You know, we really have had some great experience getting our team involved from a content standpoint. And I think that's been really strong.
I love that. And for those of our listeners that do not follow Stadium Goods on any social media, I highly recommend checking it out. There's also a very funny recent TikTok that was posted in the new Hazard beanie. Shout out to Chuck, because I know he was featured in it. But he was just showing all the different activities that you can do while wearing the Stadium Goods Hazard beanie. And it was like, you know, directing air traffic and construction work. It was hilarious.
Yeah. You know, I think that's one of the things that's great about where we're at today with social content in general is you can be fun. You can be inventive. You can come up with unique ways to look at things. It doesn't need to be so serious. And that's a great example, you know, seeing Chuck in that Hazard hat. And I like that Hazard beanie. To me, that's like a, wow, I'm surprised no one's ever made it quite like that before hat. So yeah, I wear that one with pride also.
Exactly. And what a versatile piece. All right. And so now also, you know, we're both in SG apparel. So why not take some time to talk about the Stadium Goods and Stadium apparel lines? Would love to know how this idea came to life.
You know, I think with Stadium Goods specifically versus Stadium, right? People have traditionally looked at store brands as store brands. And as we were selling our Stadium Goods tees and sweatshirts and things earlier on, it was a little slower to kind of gather that steam in the first few years of our business. That it made us think about how we could really craft a new narrative around a brand that was standalone, separate from the platform and the retail. And as we were digging around, we realized we had an opportunity to lock in the trademark for Stadium. And Stadium, obviously a very strong word, strong brand that you could create behind that word. And we caught some luck coming around the turn and locked in that trademark and got that trademark so that we could put the word Stadium on apparel. And then for us, that was really how we saw not transitioning, because we do have these two separate presences, but really creating something special that we can build upon with Stadium to elevate the quality of the materials, the broadness of the offering, like really build it as a standalone brand. And Stadium Goods is always going to be a fixture, but in our mind, Stadium has legs on its own, and it's something that we can create that's separate from Stadium Goods. And that's obviously where we are today. We've launched many SKUs under Stadium and Stadium Goods at the same time, but building out the catalog across both fronts and then leveraging our family dynamic with Farfetch, it's created some incredible opportunities for us to present these brands to new consumers. And, you know, long story short, it's resonating. We're seeing it grow aggressively. We're very excited about it, and people are excited to wear our products, and they merchandise well with everything else that we sell across the different channels. So it's been really exciting to see it come to life. So yeah, it's still very early days, but something that Jed and I and our whole team are very, very excited about and proud of.
Yeah, I'm definitely an enthusiast of the Stadium Goods apparel and Stadium apparel lines. You know, when I've gone home to visit family, they're like, oh, what is that brand? I'm like, this is Stadium Goods, or this is Stadium. You know, this is, you know, one of the partners that I work with through Farfetch. And then they're interested. Oh, can we get some socks? Can we get this? My nephew only gets shoes from Stadium Goods now. I mean, this is shoes, not apparel, but he still wears the tag. You know, he doesn't want to cut off the tag. He wants people to know where he got the shoes from. So I think you guys have done an incredible job building the brand, and then, right, being able to expand into the category of apparel, and then even now have these two standalone brands, which is just amazing.
Shameless plug, the socks. I believe the socks are the best socks in the game for the
hands
product.
Down.
They're incredible quality. The colors are fun. You know, I think that just basic white gym socks that the majority of people have been wearing their whole lives with sneakers, it's time to put those on the shelf and get something that's more comfortable and vibrant. And that's been incredible to see too, is watching our sock program grow.
Who knew it could be so fun to just visually see so many socks on social media? Every time I see the like socks on Instagram or something, they're always displayed in this very exciting way, or there's these colorways I've never seen before. So they're just even fun to look at.
They are.
All right, John. Well, I think we're going to be wrapping up our conversation for today, but I wanted to give you also a moment to plug anything for our listeners. Of course, we doubled down on the socks already, but if there's anything else you have going on, or, you know, anything that you wanted to shout out during this time, please feel free.
Yeah, look, you know, it's I talked a lot about the Stadium Goods team, but we obviously have a very close relationship with Farfetch as well. And we love working with everyone on the Farfetch side, and it's been incredible getting to know all the different people and faces over the course of the past few years. And it's still very early days, a lot of incredible things left to come. So look forward to a day when we can all meet in person and grab a drink or hang out, you know, see each other in our respective offices, whether it's LA or London or Shanghai, you know. So that was something that we all very much miss, is a lot of that time together. But hopefully we're nearing the end of this predicament, and that's not too far away. So look forward to seeing everybody.
Well, we look forward to seeing you as well. And yeah, I think we couldn't be more excited to have Stadium Goods as a part of the Farfetch family and be one big, you know, family. And, you know, for me personally, I've worked at Farfetch for about 8 years now, and this is definitely one of the highlights of my career at Farfetch, having the opportunity to sit down and have this conversation with you. So thank you. I appreciate it so much.
Thank you for that. You're making it.
And thank you to all of our listeners. Please be sure to check out other episodes of the Farfetch Threads podcast, and we will see you soon.
All right. Take care, guys.
Thanks for listening. Make sure you never miss an episode of Farfetch Threads by subscribing to our Spotify and Farfetch People YouTube channel. If you're ready to do what's never been done, visit farfetchcareers.com.